Hey guys, it's Bo. How we doing? Alrighty, put something together for you today, and I hope you guys enjoy the show. Stay tuned. Hey guys, it's Bo.
This is Shelby.
How we doing, guys? How we doing?
Could be better.
Yeah, could be. Well, I left my Xbox on. Anyways, little light color type thing where we kind of just testing it out, see if, you know, it's not as bright as our other videos that we have been doing. So, anyways, this is getting out of hand. It's getting out of hand. The coronavirus, the stores are getting empty and everything else. I mean, yes, we said this with our other video and everything that you guys probably seen already, but we just found out something else, that a store was jacking up the prices illegally to make more money because of this virus. And Shelby over here has information about that, and let alone able to tell you what store it is. Shelby, what store is this? What are we talking about here?
Well, for the ones that watch this and know my history, like this one here should, which he probably doesn't remember half of it. The store you guys are probably very familiar with. Some of you aren't. Some of you aren't. No, it's not Lowe's. No, it's not Home Depot. Not Myers or anyone like that. This store we're talking about is Menards. Yes, I sound like a pirate. Menards. So, what they're doing ever since the coronavirus outbreak came in effect, they have been skyrocketing their prices on their toilet papers, their cleaning supplies, their bleach, sanitizer, soaps, you name it, they're raising it. The Attorney General in Michigan sent them a letter because they had investigators even go to the stores and look for themselves on this. So they ended up getting that letter through them, and now they have 10 days to respond back to the investigators. Otherwise, legal action will be enforced against Menards, against the legal actions that they're doing right now.
This is ridiculous.
It
really is, because, you know, she works at, if you guys are familiar with it, Dick's Sporting Goods, Dick's store. So she works there where there's a lot of sport activities, rifles, guns, and everything else. And she's been getting phone calls when she's at work, you know, asking for, you know, AK-47 ammo and everything else. We have, about a 55-year-old man walks in and wanted to buy a hunting bow with a whole bunch of arrows and everything else. Like, what are we doing? Everybody's taking this way out of hand, and it's ridiculous.
They're getting to the point to where, you know, you guys go into a store, you buy a rifle, you buy any sort of knife or ammunition. Either if you look under the age of 40, you have to show an identification, just like you're doing for alcohol or tobacco sales. If you are over the age of 40 and you look it, they don't have to ask for your ID. They may just ask for your date of birth. The guy bought a bow? Yeah, he's not kidding. The guy refused to give his actual date of birth. He made up one of April 1st of 1912. And he says he does the same thing for his own job. It's like, we don't have your name. We don't have your social. We don't know where you live. All we're doing is asking for your date of birth to make sure you are legal to buy a weapon from us. It not only is saving us our jobs, but it's saving our store and our company from not being able to lose their privilege of selling ammunition and guns and ammo.
I mean, it's getting to the point to where, remember that one photo you showed me where the X's were on the floor?
Oh, yeah.
I believe that was at the Walmart at the deli section. Was it Myers?
Yeah,
okay, it was Myers. Sorry, my apologies. Myers, where it started to have X's on the floor, that's where people have to stand so far apart.
6 feet.
6 feet apart to where it prevents from people catching, you know, this illness and everything else. It's just getting out of hand. It really is. Everybody's acting like it's the end of the fucking world, and it's really, really, like, annoying. It really is. It really, really, really is. I mean, I understand there's already lives lost, but if you pay attention to the news on the people that are lost their lives, it's either young kids that are too young for their bodies to recover from it, or it's elderly people that already have breathing problems and everything else. But with strong people, you know, middle-aged people, like between me and her and you guys out there, everybody is different. Everybody has different immune systems. Some people are stronger than others, and some are weaker than others. Yes, I understand that. But I can't even go and freaking drive down the street without having traffic backed up at one stoplight. I mean, it's getting to the point where you're sitting there looking both ways at a stop sign for 30 minutes. It's ridiculous.
The thing is, guys, is you probably remember how around Christmas time, everyone and their mother was sick. I'm pretty sure you remember that.
Yep.
You know, it doesn't matter where you go. Someone's coughing, sneezing, hacking up a lung. Well, guess what? Sorry to say it, but more than likely, you had the coronavirus. They're saying this virus has been around since at least end of October to, you know, on. It's been here, but since one person made a deal about it and they actually tested for it, and that's what it is, now the whole world's coming to an end. Get over it. You got over it before. Get over it again.
You see, have you guys ever seen The Walking Dead or Resident Evil, where you had those zombies and everything, where like the disease spreads, where if you get bitten or if it gets into your mouth, into your body body system or whatever, you tend to turn into a zombie? Well, that's exactly what it's reminding me of, because it reminds me of the movie between Walking Dead or any of the Resident Evil movies, let alone any zombie movie you can really think of, with the music sitting there playing on my phone and, you know, trying to call me while I'm trying to do a video and everything else, which I'm going to ignore. And my apologies on that, guys. But anyway, to recover from that phone call, I was basically saying it reminds us about the zombie movies. Any zombie movies you can think of. You know, The Night of the Living Dead, The Walking Dead, the Resident Evil movies and everything. Hello? You guys are acting like a disease is going to turn you into a zombie and everything. Next thing you know, we're doing the fucking Thriller. You know, and everything else. And freaking doing Michael Jackson and everything else. It's like, well, come on, guys. Seriously. Calm your tits. Calm down. Everything's going to be fine. And for anybody that lost their loved ones, we'll say it again. We are sorry. And you have our prayers and thoughts on anybody that has it and having a hard time recovering. You have our thoughts. You have our prayers. And she will vouch for that too. So, and everything else. Other than that, just try to relax and remain safe. And wash your paws. You know, shower daily and everything else. And you'll be fine. Mm-hmm. You will be fine.
No kissing cousins.
No kissing cousins. But anyway,
no tonsil hockey with strangers.
Can we not make any more Resident Evil movies? Except for if they're actually making a new one. We don't need an actual live version of, you know, Zombieland around here. I mean, everybody's acting like it's the end of the world. I mean, yes, I have the snuffles, but hello? I mean,
oh, wait, hold on. We're standing too close.
Oh, yeah, we got back up. Sorry, guys. You know, I don't want to...
I gotta get over here.
You know... Oh, Corona.
Right?
Come on, guys. Seriously. See how stupid that was? I mean, come on. Anyway, I think that's it.
I think so.
I think so, too. Okay. But this is Bo.
And this is Shelby.
Don't forget that subscribe button.
Hit that notification bell.
And we... out. We're signing out. Goodbye. Hey guys, it's Bo again. Hope you enjoy the show. Stay tuned for more videos to come in the future. This is Bo again, signing out.
Thank you. You're a beautiful audience. Thank you very much.
Elvis has left the building.
You were always on my mind.